Happy birthday to Kid Fucking Rock. 45 years old. 45, that's all?
Really?
He looks like an old man,
he
that
looks
Kid Rock.
1,000 years old.
I can't even hear you guys.
Can't you? What?
I've been sick since the last time we did radio together.
What, Thursday?
Fuck!
Since Thursday?
Since it started like Thursday during the show. Then I hustled the show out on Friday.
Right.
And then on the way home Friday, I just got sick on the way home. Not puking, but I just knew I'm out. I'm out!
For the whole weekend.
So everyone had a nice 3-day weekend, and I was just laying in fucking bed.
Yes, it's what Dr. King wanted. You off the streets.
What the fuck is that about? I love the black man.
Shut up. You want as many white people off the streets as possible on Monday.
Martin Luther King's a tough day, man. Can't reservations for the restaurant packed.
It was packed.
Oh, really? Everyone wants.
We were busy.
Sunday and Monday, right?
Packed.
Everybody's out this weekend. Everybody's out.
Ah, fuck. I didn't even get it. I finally got some air yesterday. I walked around my neighborhood. So, what's up, Sherrod?
Chilling.
I was making fun of you on the Instagram.
Where are you? I just got back from fucking Chase Bank.
Me and Carl don't believe you.
What? I was on
we
the one.
Don't believe you, man.
First of all, I went to the one on 42nd Street. You know, you got to go up the escalator to the second
just
floor.
Just because you still got details doesn't mean it's true.
I'm just like, you know, the asshole I took. I got the envelope in my. Okay.
I told
that's how I used to be with the cops and I got pulled over. I'm like, okay, so I was at my wife's house.
Why
you
would I have
it is,
this
right?
A Chase envelope in my, with cash in it?
Because you're rich, bro. I've seen you on every channel.
That's a point.
That's a prop.
That's a prop or something? I was like, I'm taking an envelope just in case.
I told Carl, I'm insulted. I would rather Sherrod go, oh, man, I just woke up. I'm on my way.
No,
but
I wasn't
he always
just
has
woke
an
up.
Excuse.
Listen, not for nothing. This is the Opie radio show. Like, you got to have, like, a big excuse.
No,
like, my Ferrari's broken.
Excuse. You fuck just.
My helicopter's jacked up.
First of all, I'm going to tell you exactly what happened here.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead.
I go to Sag Harbor, did my show. Great show.
It was?
Packed.
Any
it was
radio
fucking
fans?
Amazing. Mad radio fans. Took pictures with everybody.
Yeah!
It was unbelievable. The fan love was crazy.
Good.
And then I go out after. We go to a bar. We all drink and it's getting fucked up.
Shit.
Everybody get fucked up.
That's a white town, bro.
That's a white town. Okay, that's a white town,
that's
right?
A very white town.
The bartender, I give the bartender my car and say, hey, drinks on me, this whole section, some of the workers from the club and whatnot.
Right.
Take care of drinks.
Yeah.
The bartender gives my card away to another dude. I'm like, whoa, bitch, I'm the only black dude here. Who the fuck did you give my card to?
Wow,
she gave it to
really?
Some Muslim dude, she said.
No.
By mistake. And she was like, here's the good news. You don't got to pay for drinks tonight. I was like, first of all, I don't know what you charge him on my card.
Right.
Oh, God, I hope that Muslim does something bad.
Second of all,
they find your ID.
They're going to trace the ISIS shit right back
fuck.
To me.
Wait, can I say that as a joke? Fuck, you can't joke about
that
shit.
I don't think
shit.
You can. I think you're in trouble.
I'm taking that back,
listen,
man.
If the dude walked away with my ATM card with my name on it, he's a terrorist. And I can say that.
He didn't fucking give it back?
He didn't bring it back. I guess he might have been drunk or something when he left. Who knows? Gave it away.
Is it your debit card, your ATM card?
ATM card, debit, same shit. And then it was holiday weekend, so no Monday.
Yeah.
So dude. I had to wait to Tuesday to go in there. Then I go in there, and these Chase sons of bitches.
I mean, right?
First of all, they told my manager on the phone, just go in there. He go in there with his ID. He get his card. Don't no problem. Right. I go in there, and he's like, no, we got to mail it to you now.
No,
it's a new policy we did two, 3 months ago.
Why? Why do they have to mail it to you?
I don't know why, but I'm looking at this, and I'm like this. Nope.
You think it's because
manager.
You're black?
E, what do you say?
Chip settings.
Chip settings.
Yeah, I had to get my the strip on my card went, and I just thought maybe they could issue me another card.
Right.
Bank of America had to send it to me through the mail.
Right.
Yep.
So they expedite in 2 days, but I have to wait. They'll send it to my office.
So you still don't have an ATM card?
No, so I just took out cash.
They should give you a temporary card.
But why is it the E-Rock? Is it so the chip knows he's black?
How dare you, sir? My card has a chip on the shoulder.
You need some cash?
No, I'm good.
I got cash today. Take it.
Yeah, give me the cash, and fuck it. I'll take white man's cash, too. It's for Dr.
And
King.
I'm taking cash from him.
Opie strong on me today.
Yes, did you? Because the bet?
I said it's time to start handing out envelopes, bro.
So I come
his
in,
business is going up because of this radio show. I go, it's time for an envelope.
Oh.
Dude, everyone knows they gotta give the
Opie
an envelope.
Opie radio guys.
Oh, I believe it.
And then the nicest people.
They are the
they're
sweet
the
ones.
Opposite of the Twitter people.
The sweet ones come out in person. Well, that's the love. Yes. That's when you see the real love, when you see them in person.
Yeah. I think the Twitter is left over from the old days, and then I think we got some new people coming in.
It's really nice, really nice people, man.
A lot of hot girls came through to him yelling Opie. I was like, oh,
yeah.
They really love this son of a bitch. They love him. It annoyed me. hot girl was like, is Opie here too? I was like, no.
Hey, man, that's Long Island.
Yeah, you got a stronghold out there.
I'm strong on Long Island.
Yeah,
strong I don't know
Island.
About the rest of the country, but I got my people on Long Island.
They represent it, man. They represent it.
I love Long Island.
I never
girls.
Forgot about Long Island. Yeah, so I've been sick since last week because my kid came down. My kid was really sick. We ran him to the doctor like last Tuesday or Wednesday. You guys are going to be able to relate to this shit. So she goes, I'm going to test him for strep and the flu. And I'm like, yeah, whatever. She comes back like, well, this is the first I'm seeing this year. He's got both.
Oh, Jesus. He's a go-getter.
Pushing 105 temp, pushing possible hospital, all
your
that
youngest.
Shit. Yeah.
Yeah.
So it was fucking scary for like 2 days. 104.7.
Was that part of what you had too? Did you catch that from him?
Bro. I caught it after him. That's my point here.
Oh.
Because soon as my wife said, we got to bring him in to the doctor's office, this is where you guys can relate and every fucking parent out there. I'm like, oh, we're all getting sick now.
Yep.
We got to go to the doctor's office in the middle of winter. That's a guarantee you're gonna have something in 2-3 days.
Oh,
guaranteed.
I go,
don't touch anything in here.
The fucking kids. I sit away from all kids in there. I don't touch any kids. None of those toys in the office in the doctor's office. No.
Right.
My kid almost got me locked up last year. I'm at my house. Me and my wife are getting hammered.
Right.
It's like 8 o'clock at night.
Right.
We left the restaurant early. My daughter kicks my son off the bed. He breaks his arm.
Ouch. Oh
my God.
So we get to the hospital. I fucking smell like Ike Turner.
So they think.
Yes. I'm like trying to admit my son. All of a sudden, I feel it. I'm like, wait a second. This bitch is asking me questions. Like,
whoa.
I'm like, yeah, my daughter kicked him off the bed. And he's like, where did it happen? What time? Were you drinking the whole time? I'm like,
oh my God.
Shit. I look at my wife and I'm like, I'm going to go move the car. I went to McDonald's.
You're out.
I text my wife. I'm like, yo, I felt the heat coming around the corner. You know, I was like, I'm out of here. She's like, you just left us in the hospital. Your son's crying. I'm like, listen. I'll buy him an Xbox, but I ain't going to jail.
I don't blame you.
I was gone.
Because you can't trust anybody.
I was gone.
They start getting suspicious and looking at it. You ever drop your kid off at school with a black guy?
Yeah.
Oh, boy, is that fun.
Oh,
boy, is that fun.
It's crazy
now. Will, you're giving me the side look?
It's crazy now.
I had nothing to do with this shit.
And I say her mother hits her and has to walk away.
I've made it a point that I don't hit my kids. You hit?
No.
You hit?
I hit back in the day so I don't have to hit now. I one little scorcher to the bottom.
You hit
when she was two, and then she'd get to now. I never have to do anything else.
I'm a stepfather, so I.
Oh,
I,
you
I,
hit!
Oh, you're going to jail!
You hit with fucking hangers.
I'm a stepfather, so I can't hit. But I'll tell you one thing: you
walk
know
around
I mean?
The house with a tire iron.
That's not
I
my
can't
kid.
Hit my kids, but I can arrange an accident. You know what I mean? I could come around a corner, you know, bump into them by mistake, maybe knock down a Christmas tree or two. You know what I mean?
Hitting a kid, a step kid, is dude's business.
I said on this show years ago, I mean, my kids are getting up there now, man. I've been a father for 6 years now already, six and a half. And I don't hit. But if you got to hit, you hit, I guess.
Yeah, if you can hit,
you hit. I try to go down the road like, I don't think you should be hitting your kids. And man, these phones will light up like,
yeah,
fuck you.
Mind your business when it comes to hitting. But you know what? You can't abuse your kids.
No, of course not.
You can't leave marks on your kids, but you got to discipline your kids.
Oh, there are times you want to hit.
Otherwise,
there
the street's going to discipline.
You want to hit.
I agree. I don't hit my kids because I'll get locked up because they ain't mine.
Right.
But I think you should be able to light them up.
I want
to
hit my nephew more than I want to hit my daughter.
Some kids. I mean, listen, guys, I'm in like a really privileged area.
Yeah.
Some of those kids are monsters, man.
Yeah.
They're monsters. They talk to their parents like, I wouldn't even, my father would murder me.
My sister works in New York City for Child Protective Services.
Right.
And she's letting you know right now, it's fucking lockup season. You coming? Straight up.
Lock up season.
Because kids get sad and parents can't provide for holidays and shit like that.
Right.
and the kids in the house because it's cold. They ain't outside playing, and that's when scratches come, and they lock your ass up in the winter.
Wow.
They will lock you up. That's
so what is it,
me.
January and February is lockup season?
December, November
starts.
I'm going to Miami. I'll come see the kids in June.
Oh, God, is that funny.
And if you're a step-parent, if you can't get a scratch,
right.
You're gone. Period. These months, you're going. They're locking you up. Period.
I came home. My daughter had a black eye. Then I called her from the Sands in the Pocono, my wife. I'm like, what are you doing? I'm like, roulette. Safer than being in that fucking kill box.
My wife's at the doctor's with my daughter now because we think she might be getting the strep. So I'm like, don't fucking touch anything.
Yes,
you're don't done, dude. Touch anything at the doctor's office.
You're done.
Because I'm sick of my Sudafed dick. Fucking had it.
I didn't see that coming.
I'm sick of it. I want to be able to feel my dick again.
You can't feel your dick on Sudafed?
Oh, bro, man. Like
how much Sudafed are you taking?
You know you're going to take it orally,
so I
right?
I be here today.
He's taking it penally. Stuffing Sudafeds in his hole.
My right nostril until about an hour ago was just pouring. Pouring.
You just mentioned 30 years of my life.
So you just hammer Sudafed until it goes away, and then you got like a marshmallow penis for fucking days.
The same thing that runs your dick around your nose.
Sudafed dick. That's the newest. I've never
you
heard
never,
that.
You don't know about Sudafed dick? Get fucking Dr. Steve on the phone. It's a nightmare. And then your prostate kind of, you know.
Large?
It swells. It
swells up.
On the Sudafed. So now you're having shitty, dribbly fucking leaks every 10 minutes.
I had no idea Sudafed did that much to your body.
Are you kidding me?
So does if you like on some type of Cialis or something, would Sudafed work against that?
I mean, if you're on Cialis, who gives a fuck? Something good's happening.
I know, but if you're gonna use something that's gonna knock the Cialis out of your system and make shrink your dick,
when you're on Cialis, don't touch anything.
I think if you do, I'm gonna guess we should get Dr. Steve on for real.
Yeah.
If you do a Sudafed and then you do a Cialis, I think it cancels each other out.
Oh no!
I think you're back to fucking. It's like square
bucks.
One.
That explains that weekend.
I think.
You're just slapping her.
It's hard and wormy.
Yeah. It's unruly. Half veiny and unruly.
Oh, Jesus, dude. It's like, my dick's been like a mushroom cap all weekend.
Oh, my God.
It's embarrassing. Dick like an 80s bully in a sleeveless shirt. Sleeveless shirt. It's like, I'll fuck that bully up. He's not even big. 80s bully.
80s bully is the best thing ever.
80s movie bully.
Oh, it's embarrassing. And then you take the Sudafed, I don't know, it's 7 in the morning, and then that night you still can't sleep. Because you're speeding your fucking face off.
Yeah.
So you do this not out sleep all night where you feel like maybe you slept for 3 minutes, then you're awake again. Hurry at line 11, I just heard. I got to shut up for a second. Let's go to Dr. Steve. Dr. Steve.
Hey, man.
Tell him about Sudafed dick.
Oh, yeah.
What was the musical like?
I didn't know anything about that.
It makes you impotent for a little while.
What?
Dude.
You've heard those stories about people who take Viagra and they get an erection for 4 hours.
Yeah.
It's called priapism, and they have to go to the ER. Well, the drug that we use to stop that is Sudafed. That's one of them.
Really?
Yes.
Yes.
I thought Tim Mello said when that happens, just call more ladies. Here's the Tim Meadows, huh?
Wow,
call
Tim
more
Meadows.
Ladies.
He's actually funny, huh?
God, here we go.
I know.
There he go,
know.
Burning here the bridge.
Wow, that bridge. I didn't even see it. I didn't even see it smoke. That just thing went up.
I never got the Tim Meadows. I'm sorry.
It just went up.
Did you get the Tim Meadows?
Yeah, I got him.
Fair enough. Anyway, Dr. Steve, tell him more.
Yeah, so the one time that I took Sudafed for a prolonged period of time, I went to have conjugal relations and nothing
happened.
I couldn't figure out what was going on, and I realized it was the Sudafed. I felt so good during the day because the Sudafed kind of speeds you up a little bit.
Right.
But it will absolutely cause impotence. That's totally reversible, thank God.
Dude.
You know, you stop taking the Sudafed and it goes away.
It's embarrassing down
there.
It's embarrassing down there right now.
I had no idea Sudafed had that. I had no idea.
And doesn't it swell the prostate a little bit?
No, I think you're thinking more of like a Benadryl.
What you the know, fuck? I was on the Benadryl, too, because my eye blew out.
What?
Yeah. No, no problem.
What's going on? Guys?
What round was it?
Did you fall off a motorcycle?
Then my eye blew out. It was like,
what the fuck is going on with Opie?
That's all that health food. That's why he's like that.
That green tea.
I look like Ronda Rousey. Yeah, well, I can't do a lot of greens because I'm allergic to trees and grass. So I'm a mess.
So let me get this straight. How the fuck are you alive?
Yeah.
So I was on Benadryl, then I was on the Sudafed. What else did I do?
How did I not know any of this? Like, the prostate gets swollen from Benadryl or Sudafed affects your dick? Yeah. What does Flintstone vitamins do? What do two Dinos do to a nigga? What will two Dinos do to a nigga? I got swollen nipples because I took a Dino. Yeah, I'm on them Dinos.
I'm Dinos.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Sudafed side effects. Let's see. Fast pounding or uneven heartbeat. Got that. Severe dizziness or anxiety. Got that. Easy bruising or bleeding. Whoa, slow down with that shit. Fever, chills, body aches, flu symptoms. Got that.
Wow.
High blood pressure, severe headaches. Yes. Blurred vision. Yes.
What?
Ringing in your ears. Anxiety, confusion, chest pain, trouble breathing, uneven heart rate, seizure. Everything but a seizure. Yes.
This is over-the-counter shit.
This is on a Sudafed?
Less serious Sudafed side effects.
Well, dude, don't forget that's what they make methamphetamine from.
Stop making me hungry. Son of a bitch. I'm going to wave that in my face.
Loss of appetite. Loss of appetite, warmth, tingling, or redness under your skin, feeling restless or excited, sleep problems. Fuck yeah. And skin rash or itching.
Limp ass dick.
Well, I call it Sudafed dick. It's like a marshmallow, a mini marshmallow down there.
Wow.
Dude, like nothing going on.
What the fuck?
Fucking nothing.
So what if you take it, Dr. Steve, if you take this like a prolonged period of time, what can it have lifetime effects on you?
Well, no one does.
No, as far as the dick is concerned, it's reversible. In other words, when you stop taking the Sudafed, blood flow to the penis resumes. So it's probably not long-term effects. Now, for people who have high blood pressure or on high blood pressure medicine, or they have irregular heartbeats and stuff, it can cause real problems.
Now, so, blood flow to the penis. That was a Marvin Gaye album, right? There you go. I know your generation, Dr. Steve.
Speaking about blood flow to the penis, I got something to show you. Did you see the tape that came out over the weekend?
Why are you looking at me? Because it's going to ruin the sandwiches he brought in if I watch this fucking thing.
E-Rock.
Nah, I think you'll still be
Wait,
good.
We're not allowed to talk about it?
You could say, you got to say alleged. I learned that.
Alleged? What is? Oh no!
What can we say about that?
Alleged.
It exists.
I thought you were showing me for the show.
No, I was showing you because it's very illegal.
What?
Why is it illegal? Because
it was a stolen tape.
Yeah, but it's all over the internet, isn't it?
It's in some spots.
Can we talk about it?
I don't like the look on E-Rock's face. Can we just, I know it's going to gross me out.
Can we just say alleged a lot? Alleged. Oh, my God.
It's not alleged if you've seen it.
I've seen it.
We know it exists.
I don't know if it...
A lot of people know it exists.
What, the one of that dude pissing on that girl?
You saw that in the...
Yeah.
That's not just any dude.
Who is it?
Wait, are we breaking something? Are we breaking a tape today?
I'm a little... Colt D'Onofrio.
Are we bringing it back?
I would wait on this.
Colt D'Onofrio.
Why would we wait on this?
Dr. King wouldn't wait.
Yeah.
Can we say it's alleged?
Yeah, let's say it's alleged for now, yeah.
Alleged.
Just can we?
I have no idea what it is, so I just want to see it.
Some dude was pissing the shit off of some girl.
All right, I've been there before.
Yeah, yeah.
Guy had a lot of hits.
Yeah,
a lot of hits.
And it's not the Kelly. R. Kelly.
A lot of hits.
No, R. Kelly. That's a Tuesday.
Okay.
Let me see if it's everywhere. If
a lot of hits.
Oh my God, Eric is freaking out a lot.
I hope know.
It's Mike J.
Dr. Steve.
That'd be incredible.
That'd be so good.
I should have paid attention in the office.
This guy, Dr. Steve, is the only reason I'm here today. I'm like, dude, what can I do to get my shit together so I can do a fucking radio show?
All right, it's all over the place.
It is all over the place, all right?
Let's go. Huh? Oh, okay. Well, I'll let you go look at that. Is there any chance you have influenza, though? That's the thing. So just
if I
develop a fever, call me.
Let me tell you something, Dr. Steve. If I got the flu, I'm touching everything in this fucking place.
Ah, damn.
Everything!
Ah, damn! Oh, no. We all gonna be fucking
quarantined. Get a meeting with Scott Greenstein.
Oh, no.
White people go down quick, too.
Yeah, they do. Oh, they fall.
Yeah, they fall. They're done.
I already got flop sweat. I'm just gonna be fucking... I'm fucking... doing this a lot tonight.
Oh, no.
I'm so happy now I can blame something else with my wife. Honey, I took a bunch of fucking Sudafed. Leave me alone.
Sudafed dick.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
I show told me this you. Tape.
Oh, Dr. Me. Steve, one other thing. You do a Sudafed and you do a Cialis. It cancels each other out, right?
Yeah, in theory. You know, they're... Yeah, in theory, that might be... You know, if you had Sudafed dick, and you absolutely needed to have intercourse while you've got influenza, then I guess you could take a Cialis to counteract it.
Yeah. But sometimes these girls don't take no for an answer, doctor.
Sick, your blood pressure.
Got to get in this, huh?
What were you saying?
You can't just say no, man.
No,
somebody else going
to I'd have to look to see if there's a drug interaction there that would prevent you from safely doing that. I'm not aware of it if there is, but there might be.
All right.
But anyway, hey, listen.
I didn't do that.
Food medicine on demand.
Yeah.
And don't know exactly when it's going to be on after.
They're closing the curtains. This is going to be a tape.
Like, yeah, they're closing the curtains. All right. Dr. Steve, thanks for everything, buddy.
So
all
let
right,
me,
boys. Thanks. Have a great day.
Thank you, Dr. Steve. Let me get this straight. Everybody saw the tape already except me.
Not everybody.
I walked in and E-Rock's like, you got to see this.
I've never heard of this
so
before.
I thought it was for the radio show.
Right.
But now I think E-Rock was trying to just turn everybody on in the office.
Creep.
He's just trying to get a room full of hard dicks in here.
I'm not used to it.
And?
In my life, I'm not used to seeing things that aren't for the radio show.
Right, everything's
I
radio
I just
show.
Assume, all right, it's for the radio show.
Right.
Right off the bat, especially with the guys you work with.
Yes.
That explains all those burnt bridges.
Yeah, no shit.
I would not... We can look at it, but I would not play the audio.
Okay.
I know, we won't play it. I just want to play this for Sherrod.
Ah!
By
I'm
the way,
excited.
By the way, fuck you.
Why?
For that cheese shit.
What are you talking
about? On Thursday.
What cheese?
I've been off dairy, right, for
right.
a while,
right.
dairy and sugar.
Right.
And then you're describing cheese to that lady, the vegan lady from that movie Eating You Alive.
Not a real vegan.
And you lost it this weekend, didn't you?
I went home that night. And my wife goes, what do you want for dinner? I go, pizza.
The best way to move cheese around.
And I housed half a fucking pie myself. Mm.
How good do you feel?
We call it pie in New York City, by the way.
Yeah. Yeah.
What?
You feel good, though, right, after you ate it? I mean, now you're something's wrong with you, but...
It was ridiculous.
So good.
I was weak after
and
that
New York
fucking
has
show
such
Thursday.
Good pizza.
Huh?
New York has such good pizza, too. What a great place where you can get takeout that's better than most pizzas. I just had a stroke.
You gotta be careful. Yeah, you gotta be careful, Manhattan. There's a lot of bad pizza, for real.
Oh, of course.
Oh, yeah, you run across some bad... Whenever it's a pizza slash something else, I don't fuck with it.
A lot of places do it right, but there's a lot of lazy places.
If you're a pizzeria slash Dunkin' Donuts, I ain't fucking
ouch.
With you. I ain't fucking with it.
It's a numbers game, right? Because there's so right. many pizzerias, most of them suck.
Yeah.
All right. Can we say the name?
Oh, yeah.
E-Rock, we can't even say the name?
I don't know. This is... I don't know.
Yeah.
You
saw that, right?
Is that
footage of me? Sherrod got nervous for a second.
I recognize that bathroom.
Sherrod just got nervous.
Is that my tub? Oh, it's Chuck Berry again now.
I didn't say Chuck Berry.
Oh, I saw this years ago.
This one?
I don't know about this one, but I've seen him peeing on girls. Yet, like old footage from when?
Allegedly. Let's go
allegedly.
I've never seen.
Allegedly.
I've barely seen Chuck Berry.
And the quality of this video, I could honestly say... I think it's Chuck Berry.
But that was his thing. Oh, my God.
That was perfect.
Oh, my God. Yeah, this footage looks great. Like, this is clearer than what I saw.
There's two tapes spliced together here.
Okay.
But I walked in, and E-Rock's like, you got to see this. And then it's farting or something?
No.
That's the
queefing?
Yeah.
Spoilers.
You're a sick fuck, Eric.
This is Game of Thrones for your ass.
You've seen this shit.
I see another video. I didn't see this angle before.
Really?
Yes.
What's the story? Allegedly. E-Rock, back on mic.
We're trying to get
We're throwing you under the bus for this.
Thank you. One that I'm not in trouble for.
Now, he's farting on hookers. That's the title of it.
What's the story with this?
The story is that these tapes were seized during a raid in the late 80s. They raided his house for on drug suspicion, and then they also found out that he was planting cameras, allegedly, in women's bathrooms and taping this stuff without them knowing.
Okay.
And this came from that series of tapes, allegedly.
Allegedly.
Oh. Allegedly.
Allegedly, allegedly.
And there's a problem playing it now.
Yeah.
They shut it down. They shut us down.
Uh-oh.
We're shut down.
They're shutting it down. A network error caused the media download to fail partway. It could be our old computers. I mean, or it could be all the viruses in these other videos.
That's true.
You think there's some shit going on by clicking on that?
Yeah, you just got hacked by Putin.
We just took down all the serious
computer systems. Not only are you going to get everybody sick, you're going to crash all the computers.
We got a white woman with her mouth open.
Yeah, that's somebody's nana now. That's 30, 40 years ago.
And then this dude, if it is him, nana. I don't know for real. I just made a joke that I think it is, but I really don't know for sure. He's relieving himself, and she's all about it.
He's got great abs.
And then later on, she's, she's eating his ass, and then he farts.
Right in the face.
Righty rock.
Yes.
How much does that cost to do that?
I'm running about $1,300.
$1,300?
It's going to run you about $1,300.
It's going to run about $1,300.
Wow. Wow.
Wow is right, my man.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, I never tape things, really. But you know you're going to be out there if you taping like this and you're an old dude, you're going to forget. Is Chuck Berry still alive? I mean, is this dude still alive?
Yes.
Chuck Berry's still alive?
Yes.
Good for him.
What is he, 80 something?
I don't know. I'll look it up.
Oh, yeah. Then we don't know if this is fucking Chuck Berry.
I mean, if it is him, he has to clean his colon in the business.
But the video is in all the usual places, right? Huh?
Yeah.
We're trying to get there's other places with the videos.
It's a lot of black action going on over
there, right?
It's getting blocked.
The Sherrod channel.
I don't know what's going on, man. It looks like they're trying to shut down videos as we speak.
Yeah. Sherrod's got race wars on the side of this thing. Look at
this does look like my college years.
And Sherrod college. Meeting fans in Sag Harbor. Oh,
you son of a bitch. Where'd you get this footage?
She looks like she wants her money back.
Yeah, look at it. She's like, oh, that was really funny, Sherrod.
Lord have mercy.
Oh,
look at that tiny dude.
All right. Yeah. I don't know, Iraq. Are they shutting down the videos as we speak? That's crazy.
It might be that computer. By the way, yeah, he is 90 years old.
90?
Yeah.
And this video was taken 2 weeks ago, so.
He didn't have Sudafed dick.
He's in those old folks' homes in Florida.
Never.
He is in old folks' homes.
No, but
that's what he shot.
You don't take cold medicine, Carl, huh?
No, I've got
cold medicine. Will fuck you up. You might as well just be sneezy and drippy all night.
Yeah.
It's not worth it. The side effects are a nightmare. Just so you can breathe some air.
Yeah.
There you go. We got a little action now. There.
Oh, there he is. Wow. Oh, that is such a hotel room. And look at him looking like a Negro League baseball player.
Willie Mays Hayes.
He's like one of the Marnocks. You Negro League tearing that pussy up. I heard he pitched 14 innings.
Looks like he
played. No glove.
I got nothing.
Looks like he played for the Milwaukee Brewers back in 1972.
Look, she's going in, too. Goddamn.
Well, she certainly is there.
And she got the feathered 80s hair. You got to respect that. She got some Farrah Fawcett on top of a dome.
Yeah, that's some. That's quite the do.
That's somebody's nana. She's an old lady now. She's a grandma.
And then E-Rock told us not to play the audio, but then there's a fart, and it's
yeah,
it brings it all together nicely.
Can we at least play the fart? I mean,
it's a nice sorbet at the end of your meal.
That she was not expecting.
Old man, fucking.
I can't concentrate with all this side Sherrod shit going on in the side.
Just a good golly Miss Molly fart right in your mouth. I don't know what songs he's on.
That's Little Richard.
Who cares? I don't separate those blacks. Yeah, she's going in. This
there
is my...
Oh,
there
she,
we go.
She...
There we go.
Oh, shh.
Oh, oh.
She jumped up.
She got a stunner.
Oh, my God. Oh, that was too funny. And she went right back in.
She's like a Navy SEAL of ass eating.
Yeah, that's 1300. That's going to run you 13.
That's 13, right?
That's a hundo. That's 1300.
You have to throw a little extra if that happens. If you let out a fart.
You need to. I mean, it's the gentleman thing to do.
You got to tip. You got to tip out.
She's doing it right, though.
Oh, shit.
What happened?
It's like her hair breathes back, too. Like she had wind-blown hair. She like a shampoo commercial in his asshole.
She got a good golly Miss Molly.
It's like your neck. Wrong person.
Oh, my God.
Stop separating those people.
Oh, Chuck Berry did a version of Good Golly Miss Molly.
They all sung the same songs, didn't they?
Right, look it up.
She is going hard.
Why does my joke have to be accurate? Fuck it.
You know when you get an eye test and they shoot that thing of air into your eye?
You better look it up. Chuck Berry did a little action with the Good Golly Miss Molly.
You're fucking dark, like aren't you?
She was testing an air pump before she blew up a bike tire.
Eric's very dark.
Dude, I'm starting to notice that Eric is fucking total two lives. Like,
he turned me on to the down blousing thing.
This he probably eats babies and shit when no one's paying attention.
Gotta stay young.
I would love to get into that kid's head.
Oh, no, it's dark in there, man.
You think it's dark?
Yeah, that's like serial killer dark in there.
Yeah.
Darker than what's on the screen.
This chick is going in.
He's so scary.
Yeah, she's going in.
I mean, I like that she's busy with the booty hole, but she's still got time to, you know, play with the shaft and get to the ball.
Trying to find part
1,388. It's a lot of money.
I mean,
you hear E-Rock? I'm trying to find part one.
Because it's hard to follow the story now without seeing part one.
I'm trying to find part one.
You can't watch Back to the Future 2 first.
You watch it out of order. You don't know the story.
Right, right.
So this is what he was doing when his cousin called him in Back to the Future on the phone?
That was awesome. That's awesome.
There it is.
That's why you couldn't hear him.
There it is. I'm telling you right now.
That new sound you've been looking for. They gotta call you back. Let me call you back, motherfucker.
Someone has to splice that in now.
I'm telling you right now, I'm tweeting this shit out if you follow me on Opie Radio. I'm tweeting this shit out right now.
Oh no.
Fuck yeah.
There goes my Food Network contract, right in the garbage.
Oh, strong.
It's that new sound you've been looking for.
Sound like a two-stroke. Bro, CR250.
Like sheep, they're following me for the tape. Like sheep.
Clickbait.
Clickbait.
Sudafed dick says, follow me.
Right. Clickbait. Oh, in other news, just breaking for us Islanders fans, got rid of Capiano, finally.
And what'd they do?
Doug Waite named interim coach of the New York Islanders.
Oh.
Dougie! Good luck, buddy.
Let's see.
Islanders are not having a good year.
Did you see that Washington Pitt game?
The what? No.
Fucking 15 goals?
Really?
7-7? It was great. It was just yesterday or the day before yesterday?
That's a blowout, man.
It was 7. I think it was the greatest hockey game. Definitely this year because the year just started, but this season.
Nah, the year didn't just start.
January, I'm talking about.
Oh. This season
it was the best game.
When was it? Last night?
Last night.
Dude, can I tell you what I did last night?
Was it last night or Sunday night?
This is what happened last
Holidays
night.
Holidays throw me off, yeah.
I organized my entire day to have everything done with kids and all that and cold medicine and Sudafed dick and all this shit, right? So I could watch the Cavs and the Warriors.
Right.
Blowout.
Blow the fuck out. Was that the game Bert went to or no?
Oh, yeah. fucking Bert. Don't even get me started with that.
Bert Kreischer and Tom Segura went to that game on Joe Rogan's dime. They were so excited. That game was over by halftime.
Did you watch? Yeah, I watched as much as I could watch it. Fuck. LeBron went down on that fucking that fall.
He flopped.
Right then you was like, it's over.
Did you see how what's-his-name made fun of him?
Yes.
It's everywhere.
I already saw music put to it.
Oh, really?
Did you see the crying Jordan they put on LeBron's head?
Oh, no.
On that clip?
Oh, my God.
Oh, when he fell?
When he fell, they put a crying Jordan in his balding head.
Bro, he flops a lot, right, LeBron?
He's been known to do some flopping.
I love LeBron, but he flops.
Yeah, I don't like that flopping shit. That's new boy shit. That's not like NBA that I'm used to. Moses Malone didn't flop, motherfucker.
Right.
It just wasn't a flopping generation.
Cavs are in trouble, man.
Not really.
The Warriors got it together.
That was only one game, though. In a seven-game series, you're going to do that.
That is true, but it looked fucking strong.
And plus, J.R. Smith wasn't there.
Well, J.R. Smith's dealing with a mini-preemie.
Yeah, his baby, yeah.
You, you heard that about sucks. That, right?
Yeah, yeah.
His baby was born 4 months early.
Shh, but
like a pound.
Oh, that's scary.
That's
shit.
That's touch and go.
Yeah.
Fuck.
That's like, know, that's like minute by minute attention for that kid.
Yeah.
Like four doctors. I know a little bit about this.
Right.
My kids, but whatever.
Right.
Without getting into too many details. There's four doctors watching those kids like minute to minute.
Wow.
That is scary shit he's going through.
Thank God I had nothing to do with shit like that.
4 months early.
Why so preemie?
I don't know, man. Sometimes they just...
It happens, yeah.
They just want to start the basketball career.
That happens sometimes.
Maybe the kid's so tall, his legs just run was out the womb. Basketball kid. He already had LeBron's on.
You really got to pay attention to Opie. He says some fucked up shit. I'm looking at the screen. All of a sudden, it comes in through my brain. I'm like, holy fuck, that was lethal.
I'm blaming it on the Sudafed today. Pay no attention to the man behind the microphone today.
The Caps got blown out, though. It was embarrassing.
I think it was, then I went Pip. I did a little Pip action, because I'm like, maybe they come back. Picture in picture. Had that game in the right corner.
They
never came back, obviously.
78 points in the first half.
Yeah.
What is that?
They got to get, what's his name in the offense for the Cavs, the shooter.
Who? What's his name?
Whatever.
Then who they just got? We talking about
Yeah, he's lethal from the 3-point range. He's a great shooter, but they got to get.
You got to work him in, though.
He looked like
it take time.
Yeah, so they need time to get him on board and get him into the offense. We'll see. But last night was not good.
How did you not see that hockey game? It was fucking amazing,
dude. I claim to be a hockey fan. I haven't watched many hockey games this year.
That was the greatest one.
I'm watching more NBA this year because of you, because I'm looking at Westbrook now.
Yeah.
Looking at the Knicks because of you, even though they're, lost 11 out of 13 or whatever. What are they? They've lost a shitload.
Oh, the Knicks are done. I think the Carmelo, I think, is finally, I think they're going to get rid of him.
Bye-bye.
Gone.
I'm done.
Gone.
Start rebuilding.
It's time.
Start rebuilding.
Yeah, I like Carmelo.
I love him, but it's time for new shit now. It's time to mix it up or something.
He's obviously talented, but it's not working.
It's not working.
So, like, there are teams out there that want to give it a run at the Cavs and the Warriors. Trade him to somebody that feels like they got a shot. Get some young players and get some draft picks, and let's start rebuilding.
I love Carmelo. He's a great player, but it just don't seem the Knicks just ain't doing it, man. And Porzingis was out a couple games. It's like, ugh.
And you got Rose. He's a head case this year.
That final play in the Knicks game the other day, when Rose went up for the shot, he got blocked by the rim. Then somebody else went up. Then Carmelo tried to shoot and miss. It's like, this is a whole fucking career. This is a whole season right here.
Yeah, that's what the season is right there in that one, 5 seconds or whatever it was.
Bunch of losing. Just lost so much.
So where are we at? Yes, Carl.
I heard some rumors at the Lululemon at the mall by my house.
All right.
That Colin Kaepernick's coming to the Jets.
That's a possibility.
It's definitely happening.
Oh, Christ.
It smells like what the Jets would do.
This is exactly what the Jets do.
It's exactly what they would do.
Why?
Because this is what we do.
But that's almost like saying, like, you know, we're building a losing team.
Do you understand that the Packers have had two amazing quarterbacks since 92?
Yeah.
Is it 92?
Yeah. It's when first started. Yeah.
Two.
Well, look
They've
where
had
they are.
Two amazing quarterbacks.
Two Hall of Famers.
Right. Back to back. You know how many quarterbacks the Jets have had in that period of time?
1,600.
I would go close to 30.
And why is it so bad?
I don't fucking know. But I would bet that's happening.
I heard it.
I think because Mark Sanchez happening. Was such a bust in New York, he should have been, because he's a smart dude, he knows football, but it just didn't work out with him. Then he had the butt fumble and
right.
infamy.
And he hasn't really done much since then. Did you guys watch the games?
Lots of watch the games.
Aaron Rodgers is an animal.
He's an animal!
That was one of the best football games I've ever seen.
It was one of the greatest. I couldn't even be upset. I was proud of my team.
You should be upset. Cowboys got lately lost.
No, we lost. We lost by 3
yeah.
points.
Beautiful points.
It's all right, but we could have got blown out.
No, you didn't.
We could have got the Jets done too. I mean, the Giants.
You got a franchise quarterback. They gotta look past Romo officially now. They pretty much have this year, but the kid did all right, man.
The full rookie years, Zeke and Dak had amazing seasons for rookies. Like, who has a rookie season like that as a quarterback?
Right,
he's incredible.
And
I'm so happy.
I thought he was gonna fall apart because that game was so tight. And he was still right in there, man.
Yeah.
He was in there.
He was in there, yeah.
You guys got a quarterback, Lewis.
which is it's great to have. I'm still disappointed.
And I'll tell you that game. Most
so
of the,
mad.
Most of the playoff.
Lewis is heated.
He's mad. He wears Kwame shirt today.
It's Kwame shirt.
Okay, Carl.
That was great.
Nice.
He Philadelphia'd it.
Right. Got jokes today. All right.
Oh yeah, we're on fire. We got Sudafed. You want some?
I'm good. I'm good.
I mean, we did lose, Lewis, but it was a good battle. We should have started stronger, though.
We should. That's the problem that I have. I don't understand what the coaching staff was doing. Your running back is getting 4.5 to 5 yards a carry. Why on 3rd and 2 are you throwing the fucking ball?
Yeah.
Just line up the ball and run.
Just because they're thinking you're going to run it.
That's fine. We played them. They had 7-8 in the box before we ran it on them.
I always play that shit the opposite way.
What?
What's that?
They're probably looking for the run, so why not give it a fucking shot?
I see what you're saying.
Give it a little
pass. I didn't see
action.
A funny picture of the dude making a catch to
Michael
Green Bay.
Michael Jackson?
I laughed
so hard. I should have let you have
Good
that.
God, I laughed so hard at that.
Sorry about that. I should have
I could hear him going, ee-hee. It was so funny.
How the fuck do these guys put those 2 feet in bounds at times? That's just amazing.
See, we used to do that when we played street ball, and you have the curve right there, so you just put your feet against the curve.
We've all done it.
Right, but doing it on the line like that at high speed.
Right, that's what I'm saying.
It's unreal.
Just knowing I got to keep my tippy toes on the other side of that line, man.
You got to collapse. Like, you got to faint on top of yourself.
Yeah. Didn't one ref say no catch?
Yeah.
And then the other guy's like, hell no, we got this.
Yeah, the other guy's who I really hate.
And is it true that Aaron Rodgers just wrote up this fucking play on the sidelines like he was playing some street ball?
That's what I heard too, yeah.
You
because everybody knows the tight end kills the Cowboys almost every game.
Every game and, from the San Francisco 49ers.
For such a long time, man.
So tight ends always, they get us.
Every time. I don't know what it is about the cover two. I don't know, but Dallas cannot have a fucking tight end for anything.
For 30 years.
These Packers are peaking at the right time, man.
I agree.
The right time.
I agree.
And you know what? This game made up for all the other games. The playoffs have been a bust.
100%.
And then this one, and then the Steelers game was pretty good, too.
The Steelers game was great. I know the Steelers pull it out because they know how to pop a team in the mouth. That's what they do. They're going to pop you in your mouth. Now, if you can still win after a pop, you won.
You won.
Right.
But they're going to pop you in your motherfucking mouth.
Hell yeah. And I believe that Cowboys-Packers game was the most watched playoff game this year.
Ever.
Had like 28.2 million viewers.
I was just about to ask you that.
Highest ranked watched playoff game in NFL history.
Exactly.
Wasn't it higher than that even?
I think it's like 48 million or some shit, they said.
I feel like it was, man, Sherrod, you got your shit. That's what I like about you.
I'm on it.
you're really on it. I think the number was 48.
Let's check.
Or was that the rating or something?
I know it was the highest
28.2 overnight rating right there.
Yeah, no, that's the rating. Yeah.
How much draw though? I saw a 4.8 somewhere, but anyway, I don't know, man.
Big money for the NFL. I'll tell you that shit, and it's bigger than the 20 biggest teams.
Lewis,
100%
cash.
You went what? 2 for 4?
I went 2 for 4. I didn't do as good as other people in this room.
Did
but
you
I did okay.
Pitt? You picked Pittsburgh?
No, I picked Kansas City.
Oh,
yeah. I went 4 for 4, right?
I'm just making that up. I'm trying to be part of the conversation.
You anything.
Yes.
4 for 4.
You went 4 for 4?
Hope you went 4 for 4.
Lewis, give it to him.
Yeah.
4 for 4.
You went against
four.
The Cowboys, you son of a bitch.
4 for 4.
You picked the Packers and the Steelers.
But why didn't you tell me that shit? We can gamble together. I can make you a ton of money.
Well, I got beat up on Instagram. I poked a little Instagram live as we were getting ready for the show today, and a guy's like, that's... If you're not using the point spread, that doesn't mean shit going 4 for 4. He's kind of right.
Yeah, but if you're not gambling.
He's kind of right.
Unless you're gambling your family's earnings away.
What would it have been?
They should fend for themselves.
Does anyone know what it would have been with the points?
I don't.
It definitely wouldn't have been 4 for 4, that's for sure.
I don't know.
I didn't bet. So. After the Giants, I'm not betting anymore. I lost everything. My kid's not going to college.
Yeah, one of my dudes, a friend of mine, he just showed his ticket on Twitter. He bet $300 a few months ago.
On the Cowboys?
On the Green Bay. Shit like that. And he won $28,000.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah. Son of a bitch.
Is he rolling it over?
I don't know.
Is he rolling it over?
He's a degenerate.
The most degenerate trigger I've ever seen. He didn't even flinch.
Is he rolling it over? That Sudafed didn't stop your degeneracy.
I used to work the football gambling sheets in high school.
Uh-huh.
Got into it from the assistant basketball coach. He pulled me aside. He knew I was weak.
Boy in the bubble.
He's always sick.
Now that I'm older, I'm like, that motherfucker knew I was weak. It came from a poor family, that motherfucker.
Holy shit.
So he's like, hey, man, you want to make a little extra money? I'm like, well, slow the fuck down with that shit.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
So then we went to the other side of the school where
he's looking around. He's looking around his studio.
But what?
Well, I mean, we used to call them waterheads.
Okay.
The jellyheads?
Well, we had a jellyhead section in our school.
Yeah, right?
Well, you had a whole section was like trailers out there.
Dude, there was a hallway that you just didn't go past. I think the lights were even dimmer.
Yeah, because they get crazy if the bright lights.
The whole school would have action, and then this one hallway.
Yeah.
You just, the word got out day one, and like, yeah, you don't go down there.
You drop your lunch tray, fucking things pop off, the jellies go nuts. Right.
Assistant coach goes, we're going down there. I'm like, all right, what the fuck? And then he let me in that it wasn't going to be some weird fucking sex shit.
It was football shit. Allegedly.
No mouth fart.
So then I became the kid that was handing out the sheets every week.
Really?
In my high school.
Good for you, man.
And then I had to pay my math, was it a math teacher? I got to get this right. One of my teachers hit, like 12 for 12.
What?
For a big number. And then the whole class, he's just looking at me. And I'm like, don't worry, I got your fucking money.
No shit.
Swear to God.
You used to ride like that?
And then he wanted me to do it when I went to Geneseo, when I went to college. I'm like, I'm out, bro. I'm out. I was out. I think I did one season, maybe two. I'm trying to remember.
Wow.
This is so many fucking years ago. But I had to pay off one of my teachers a big number.
That is inappropriate shit.
What's a big number?
It was over a thou.
That's a lot, man, for a little kid to see that kind of money.
I was like, I was in probably 11th, maybe, yeah, probably 11th, I think I was doing.
Who was your muscle if someone didn't pay?
The fucking assistant coach, I guess.
Yeah, he would clean them
up. I would meet him in the weird section of the school, and then we would fucking do our transactions. He would give me all the people I had to pay out.
Wow.
Good for you, man. That's why you're successful. That was real school. What you were doing besides was bullshit.
I agree.
Fuck that, man.
You learned how to read people.
I was hustle,
grind it out, Opie.
I was Candyman. I think he knew I was Candyman and goes, fuck the candy fucking scheme. You know, I would bring candy to school and then people would pay me.
What drugs are candy? What would that mean?
Just regular candy.
I don't want to talk about selling candy. But
then hike up the price.
That's how Cuban he is.
Yeah.
Is that we talking coca?
I'm not like candy. I'm like, what does that mean? What weight is that exactly?
this motherfucker knew I was weak.
How many
he
kilos
knew I was
of
weak and poor.
You're wrong, sir.
And used you. Maybe he knew you had needed opportunity.
He knew you were strong.
I needed the money.
He knew you were strong. He knew you were a grinder.
I don't even remember what I was getting a week or any of that stuff anymore.
Opie plays that LL Bean shit, but he's a fucking gangster.
Yeah, he's from the street. He's dirty.
Yeah, I'm from the street, all right.
The salty streets of Long Island.
Of Huntington.
Huntington, Long Island.
Not even Huntington Station.
That's funny. If I said Huntington Station, a few people would go, oh, okay.
All
right. No, Huntington. So what do you think coming up with these games now?
I'm everything right now is like a toss-up. The Green Bay and Atlanta game is just going to be a shootout. It might as well be 80-65. Yeah. Really, they are going to be throwing a lights out in that.
I honestly don't know shit about Atlanta.
Atlanta's going to win.
They look good, though.
They always look good.
They look good. I don't know shit about them.
Until they look bad, one game is in the playoffs. It's like, oh, fuck, I can't believe in Atlanta no more.
Right. Atlanta's going to win. You heard it here first.
But they need one.
Matt Ryan's never, I don't believe he's ever been to a Super Bowl, so.
Well, Atlanta hasn't been to a Super Bowl since when?
Mike Vick didn't get him, man.
No, Mike Vick never again.
Should I go 99 on this?
Was it even then?
I don't remember. So. Somebody look it up. They haven't been in a while, man. What? I
believe
it's 99. 99. Oh, nailed
it. 90 wow. fucking
9. Yes. He's on fire.
The candy man.
He's on fire, man.
Huh?
Super Bowl 33.
Wow. I got to go Pats all the way.
Yeah. You think they're going to win it all? Who do you not want to win, Louis?
It doesn't matter anymore. As long as there wasn't anybody in the NFC so East, Giants, right? I don't care.
Okay.
Well, the story would be Atlanta winning the whole thing.
Yeah.
That's pretty obvious to everybody. They have to be the underdog as far as those four teams go.
But I think...
Just in general, I don't know if they're the weakest team. I don't know that shit.
I think New England knows how to beat every team left.
Hell yeah.
I think every team left, they know how to beat them.
It was shaky with Houston for a little bit there. And then they were like, all right, we got this.
Yeah.
And Houston did pop Brady a couple times, so maybe that'll affect him this week.
Yeah.
Come on, bro. He's like a cyborg, man.
Cyborgs. No, why? Because when he gets hit too hard, he fucking gets mad at everybody, and then the ref's like, all right, I'm sorry, Mr. Brady. I'm sorry, that'll never happen again.
Don't get me fired.
He really got more control than anybody on the field.
Well, he tries to think, whatever. Some people think the league's against him and stuff, but they also listen when Mr. Brady fucking talks if he's been hit too hard.
Yeah. He has an aura. When I met him, bro, like...
You met him?
Yeah. I met him. And
I think I saw a picture. Did I see a picture of you and him? Or no, that was.
I was with him, and it's my kid met him and made it a complete embarrassment and mockery out of the whole fucking thing.
Why? Yeah.
He wouldn't shake his hand.
Oh, you told me this story. Yeah.
He wouldn't shake his hand. It was embarrassing. My kid turned into a piece of fucking IKEA furniture.
Your kid wouldn't shake Tom Brady's hand because he's a Giants fan?
My kid went full jelly. It was embarrassing, bro.
I like that. I respect that.
I respect that too.
Well, everyone thought he was making fun of him. You know what I mean? Like, or he didn't like him, but he wanted to meet him the whole day.
He's a kid, though. Why would that be embarrassing?
Yeah, he's such a child.
Because he wanted to shake his hand the whole time.
Yeah, but how old was he?
10 years old,
dude.
He was shy.
I'll tell you right now, if Brady walked in that door, I'd be like, I'm gonna.
Big dude. Man.
I would blow him.
I'm 5'7", so everyone's kind of big for me, but. Fucking big dude, man.
Yeah, he's a tall dude.
Edelman was small when I met him. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, small guy.
Hey, what was the Facebook Live that happened over the weekend, Lewis?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, did you hear about this?
Yeah, the Steelers wide receiver.
I love how some of these people just don't understand the technology yet.
And the coach yelled at them, too.
In trouble, right? Yeah.
What a dumbass.
Yeah, he just, after they won the game, he had his Facebook Live going in the locker room, hanging out, you know, jamming with the rest of his teammates. Is that your son?
Yeah. Look at him not shaking his hand.
Look at the guy putting his hand on my son's head, like thinking that, you know, something's wrong with him.
And he will not shake his hand. His hand's out.
That was so long, standing there.
That's hilarious. How long ago was that?
That was this summer.
Where were you guys?
Amazing.
We did a Best Buddies. So I went with the Food Network and Tom Brady and the Food Network and Guy Fieri do a Best Buddies thing in Boston for special needs kids.
Amazing.
So we went and we cooked and everything. And Boston people are the fucking... They will tell you to go fuck yourself in 3 seconds.
They're
like old
the
Brooklyn.
Best.
Like not New Brooklyn's gone. It's gone.
There's just some traces of it. Some
very
little
few.
Pockets.
Little pockets.
Why don't we go up there and do a show?
Oh, I love Boston. Fucking the
food.
Yeah, we should.
Let's just do a show.
The food in Boston. And believe it or not, it's got a great Little Italy, man.
We gotta take this show on the road.
I used to go to North End.
Road it up.
Fucking North End has good fucking food, man.
Yeah.
Let's go up there.
Let's do it.
Start some fucking mayhem. Love Bean Town.
I'm gonna go local for you.
Sandwiches. He's trying to keep your sandwich.
Wait, you don't have your Cuban sandwich yet?
Yeah, he already showed us the pictures of it.
He showed you the pictures?
But he did, but
I
Roland
to physically give him a sandwich.
Roland is trying to keep the sandwiches to himself.
Roland will not give anyone the sandwiches.
Here we go, Antonio Brown. But luckily for Antonio, he's the best player on the team. So
true, but they are going to discipline him and fine him because that was definitely breaking the NFL social media rules.
Yeah, media rules.
Yeah. So how much are they going to fine him for?
The team would pay it if they won the Super Bowl.
So here's Antonio Brown doing a little Facebook Live. And,
Mike Tomlin.
Let's say very little moving forward. Let's start our preparation with these assholes a day and a half.
He called the Patriots assholes.
Is anyone surprised by that? Is that the problem here?
That's it.
Oh please! They're all calling each other assholes. We're gonna make believe that's not happening in the locker room.
I don't think that's news.
Media makes a big deal about it, then they got to ask Bill Belichick, who's the best person in the news conference I've ever seen.
He's
amazing.
Snapface, he called.
Yeah, he just started shitting on.
I don't watch Snapface.
Did he say that?
Yeah, like the little teenagers. Like, man, I don't do that Snapface Insta stuff.
I don't do Snapface. I love him.
He is the best.
Isn't that great?
He's Clint Eastwood in Gran Torino.
Right? Yes.
Yeah. Oh, yes. Hell yeah.
I don't do snap face. Get off my lawn.
I just love that he shows up for the Super Bowl in a shitty hoodie. It's just the best. He don't give a fuck.
He woke up in that hoodie.
Right.
That's what makes him one of the best. He don't give a fuck about anything but football.
I don't even think he cares about winning it.
He sounds like a great father.
I don't know if he even enjoys winning a Super Bowl.
I bet you he locks the fucking door of his house and he screams for a week when it's done.
Really? Yeah.
Those people like that, I mean, he goes home, he gives his wife a right hook, puts her right in the fucking carpet,
got a girlfriend.
Starts drinking. Yeah, she gets it.
He got a girlfriend? She hot?
I don't
look
know.
At it, look at it.
I see why he's so grumpy. That motherfucker, holy shit. He's dressed like he's still a wrestler from high school.
he's like Roland Campos in football.
It's like money.
Look at those socks.
Yeah, right on.
God bless him.
I'm sure.
He's got every nickel he ever made in the NFL. He's never spent it on gold.
He's
going to
be rich for 300 years.
Yeah.
What is that?
That is the best. They put a model.
You got to explain.
It's Fashion Week. They got him running down, walking down a runway.
They put him in a Fashion Week setting.
Belichick. He's in the back.
Oh,
that is
funny.
An incredible picture.
That motherfucker loves wearing his knockaround shorts. Give me my knockarounds. My slippers and my knockaround.
He's never had sweaty balls, bro. He's always
I bet
fully
he has
ventilated.
100 knockaround shorts.
His whole closet is knockaround.
Kind of like the Jay Leno where he has a million blue shirts. That's what Belichick has.
He's every dad on his day off.
I've never heard that term. Knockaround
really?
Shorts.
Yes.
Oh, we all have our knockaround shorts, but you don't leave the house with them. You don't play in the Super Bowl with them.
That sounds right? Like wealthy talk. Honey, my knockaround shorts.
My knockarounds.
I might have to contact Brother Ruiz, I was listening to him this morning, and he was talking about some kind of bet where they were rolling it over week after week.
I think that might be the same thing.
And it's getting crazy.
Yeah, he's up to like 76,000 right now.
Whoa!
Wait, you know the story?
I kind of glanced over that story, yeah.
Why would he glance over that?
They roll
like a gambling story.
Wait, I want to know exactly who's rolling it over.
If you could find that, or maybe I'll get Weez. Weez, you listening? Fucking call me, man.
How much money? How much potential winnings is that, Ope? If it was 76 or something.
I was half listening because I had Sudafed dick. But Weez was talking about something about rolling it over. Yeah, I listen to him every morning.
Who's that? I've never heard
Brother
of
him. Brother Ruiz, he's my mentor.
I want to know if you roll it over and win this week. What is that then if he got 76 now?
I don't know. Let's try to find the story. All right, so pick the games, bro.
So that'll be 1.2.
Who's the Super Bowl?
Patriots.
And?
I got to go Atlanta.
Patriots.
Okay. I can respect that.
Atlanta's going to the Super Bowl. I'm telling you.
I think NFL, they want fucking Packers, Patriots, obviously, right?
Definitely.
Well, who turn is it to get beat by Tom Brady? Then Aaron Rodgers already take
Rodgers
that beat.
Yeah, are you kidding? Aaron Rodgers is on fire, man.
He's on fire, but
there's something to be said about hating your family.
And he's got a hot girl who came in here before.
Ah, she stinks.
You don't like her personality?
No.
You never was into half Asians.
No, she just had an attitude.
I love half Asians.
Well, she's just snarky.
Jimmy liked her. I
liked her a lot.
I despised her. She just comes across like just not nice.
She's got a little
bitchy.
Snark to her, but I like it.
And then she had her winter coat on. Help me out, Paul.
And then she complimented your shirt.
You can't see the lips.
She complimented your shirt.
Yeah.
What kind of shirt?
I forget what you're wearing. It's in the video.
My Opie Radio t-shirts?
Oh, my God. I knew that one. I saw that one coming.
There you go. $300 bet.
Here we go. All right. So the story goes, the idea began before Thanksgiving, and the first game was on November 28th. Brian and Russ wanted to place a $300 bet on one team and roll the winnings over every week until the Super Bowl. Yeah, everyone should do this every year. $300?
Yes.
With the potential of winning something crazy?
And now it's 28?
Until the Super Bowl, according to ESPN. The guys picked the Green Bay Packers, who are currently on an 8-game winning streak. So they've been picking the Packers for 8 straight weeks? Let's see. That streak began on Monday, November 28th. Come on. Oh, that great time to click on something there,
Paulie. I would cash the fuck out.
immediately.
No
Fuck
kidding.
That.
The streak began on Monday, November 28th in Philly against the Eagles. A 27-13 win. The initial 300 bet has yielded $28,213.60. Wow. But Brian and Russ are keeping things rolling, placing all of it on the Packers' money line against the Atlanta Falcons
and
in the NFC Championship game on Sunday. The Packers are slight road underdogs. If the Packers win, the near $30,000 will become $76,000 on a $300 bet.
Oh, wow.
Strong.
We could have bet like four teams and did that shit.
And if the Packers assholes win the Super Bowl, this $300 that these guys started this with in November 28th will be worth $150,000.
That's it, man. What the fuck are we doing?
You could Chuck, you could Chuck Berry like 30 girls for a month.
Do you roll it?
What you
two to go.
No.
You're at 28. Do you roll it two more times?
Walk out on 28. 28's good.
This is like the wall on NBC.
Right? I'm watching that dumb shit too.
Do you roll this shit?
28,000 from 300 is a lot of money. That's a lot of markup. I think I'll roll it.
Yeah, but now they're becoming famous. I mean, this story's going everywhere.
But Opie, what's stopping us from picking like four teams and putting 300 on each team? And it's letting them all ride.
Each week.
A lot of people do that.
I mean, even the ones we lose, if we got one that's going, it's going to pay for
one
all
out
that.
Of four, but I mean, you need the streak.
You need the streak. That's the problem.
You need the streak.
He's damn. Right.
This is eight games in a row.
To be Biff and dude, fucking Back to the Future with that fucking sports catalog book.
Who would think the Packers are going to win eight in a row like they did?
Yeah.
True.
I mean, they turned it around, obviously.
Aaron Rodgers called it, though.
He did call it. Run
yeah,
the
what
table.
Did you say again?
I'm going to run the table.
Run the table and ain't lose since he said it. God damn it. Why can't that, like, that?
Why do people not like him? People say he's an asshole, like, in real life?
Something's going on.
Like, he doesn't
people
talk to his
family?
People
think that he might be a little...
Something's going on.
Remember people had those stories out when he was...
I got my theories.
Uh-oh. What are they?
Just got some theories.
Uh-oh.
Tell me, Street Opie.
Tell me.
First of all, you know he's not speaking to his parents right now.
That's what I mean.
His parents didn't come to the game, didn't watch the game.
They watch.
Well, that's what they said. He said they said fame changes things.
Fame changes
things.
That's
the father's quote.
That's pretty fucked up.
That's fucked up to be saying it, even if it's so. It's like,
so what's that about?
I'll tell you what that is.
Because Aaron seems like, I mean, we only know his personal, public persona. Jesus.
Right.
He seems like a nice guy.
Nice enough. Went right? to a nice little school in Northern California, right?
He said no.
He's another quarterback that's a bore in commercials, though.
I like his no, fucking double
you
check.
Don't.
The
you
double
don't
check
like,
was huge.
You don't like his commercials.
They had 9,000 of but the fact no,
that
it wasn't him. I'm gonna say I like him. You know what I like? I didn't like him. I like that fat dumb dude who was in it who reminded me of fucking Brian Scalaro with crazy hair. The fat dude was like, double check.
Oh, okay. All
right, right.
I like dumb silly niggas like that.
He did something. His parents asked him for a loan or something, and he said no, and then it got weird. It happens every fucking day.
Yeah, there's a lot of sports athletes with stories like that.
I'm telling you.
Yeah, but, I mean, he's got enough money to give a few to his parents if that's the
but
case.
But he's not obligated.
I think it's way deeper than that.
But it's not an obligation.
It's
you're
not
right.
an obligation. Opie, you should know. You of all people
what
should know that.
What? I have people coming to me all the time.
All right.
Yeah.
And then what do they say? They say, you're the piece of shit.
Yeah, if you don't give them the money.
I could fill up a Walmart with people that have asked me for money.
You know what I could have bought with the money I gave other people over
imagine,
the years?
Imagine how
are
much...
Are you in the same boat as
well,
me?
Well, here's the thing. The people that ask you for money,
right.
you're smarter than them anyway because you got money, right? You know that the investment that they're going to make sucks.
Right.
Well,
so you just watch them squander it on some stupid, like...
Well, that's why it's better to give and not loan.
No, I got,
if you love the person, just give it to them. Don't loan it to them because it's going to make you hate them.
I got tougher over the years because it was getting crazy.
Yeah.
I'm like, look, you come to me with a half-decent idea. I'm not just paying your bills. I can't do that anymore. Mm-hmm. You come to me with some kind of nice business and you need a little help with that, I'm in.
Chuck Berry tapes.
That was my line, though, after a while.
I learned this from a celebrity once. He told me, listen, he tells when people ask him for money, he says, if a bank won't give it to you, then why the fuck would I?
Yeah.
It's family, though.
Get rid of them.
That's the thing.
People tell me with family, whatever they ask for, give them maybe a third or half of it.
That's family.
Help them out. You can't turn your back on fam 100%.
Absolutely you can. Give them a gift certificate.
Right.
I think these guys are stuck rolling it, by the way.
What do you mean? Oh, yeah.
Because it's the story now.
Yeah. You can't
you're
pull
stuck.
Out now.
I would only
if
roll
it,
half.
If they didn't make it to ESPN.com, then maybe you sneak out. But now you can't. You got to roll.
76.
and then 150 off of $300.
Well, it would go, they're up to 28, then it goes to 76, and then 150.
I'm out at 76 if it's me. I'm not taking that chance.
You're right. You're right.
I'm not taking that chance.
Yeah, I'll probably stay in for 28, but I'm going to pull it out at 76. Right. I mean, goddamn it.
Because they can end up with nothing, right? And that would be the story. Nobody would give a shit about you. They would just make fun of you for the rest of your life.
Yes. Right.
What an asshole. $76,000.
Stay strong, Philly. Stay strong.
The Candyman says.
You also got to understand what city this is coming from.
Yeah.
Philly ain't fucking backing out. Never.
They're going to let it roll.
I've seen some shit down there.
Philly, winning and losing is exactly the same thing in Philly.
Oh, my God.
It truly is.
It's true. It's
fucking
the story.
Beanie Siegel said that.
Yeah.
We started from the bottom to get to the bottom. Philadelphia.
Let me tell you something.
Beanie, baby.
I'll say this. Baltimore doesn't back out. Philly doesn't back out. Give me a city that would back out on this bet.
West Coast, make a big circle around the whole West Coast.
You don't got no faith in San Francisco or L.A.?
That's the softest part of the country you've ever seen in your life.
You are, Leo. Get a little
I opened a restaurant. For somebody in California. The third day I was there, 36 people sent an email that they couldn't work with me. That
why?
I was a monster. So they pulled me into the office and said, Carl, listen, we know you're a really talented chef from New York. Please, look at all these emails that we got.
But what were you
they're
doing?
They're babies. They're babies.
I was telling them that they were garbage. Because they were. But they were. We're opening a restaurant. It's a war.
Yeah.
Right?
I know.
So
I've seen Carl in action. It's yeah. crazy.
So listen. So they tell me, Carl, please, just this is California. Be nice. Why don't we set up a little group meeting with all the staff?
Right.
And you tell them a little bit about yourself.
Oh, no.
No.
God, no.
No.
Lord
no.
I said, no problem.
Oh, God.
Now the staff is all empowered because, like, oh, they calm down Carl, right? So they set up all the folding chairs at the restaurant 2 weeks before we open.
Right.
And I get there. And I'm like, it's come to my attention that some of you don't like me. Jared, Gary. That's when they knew all of a sudden. Don't fucking, it was the worst thing they ever did to me.
Right. Oh, that's great.
I said, raise your hand, anyone that's gotten reviewed here by the New York Times. They all sit there. I says, exactly. We're going to do it my way, or you're going to go back to your little job at Dave and Buster's, where the fuck you came from. And the guy comes, he goes, okay, Carl, thank you very much. Take care now. But after that, they're like, all right, he's a psycho. But we opened the restaurant.
Did he keep most of those people? Was it a bloodbath?
No, I fire them automatic. First staff you fire, boss. They're dirty. They got cancer.
You just get rid of them right away.
Yeah, because the first staff is, it's like think about a rocket going into space.
Yeah.
You know, if you have different fuels, the opening staff has different, you know, different traits than the lifers.
Right.
You know, and you want the good-looking people. You want the thin people.
You want energy.
You want that energy, that, hi, how are you? Like those real psycho-y people.
Not somebody already set in their ways there.
Right, you want all the actors and stuff, but they don't last.
Right.
That's why they are who they are.
They want something bigger than that. Right. They move on. I get it.
Makes sense.
Shit.
Yeah.
One other sports story. Moving companies are refusing to move the Chargers. You see that, Lewis?
What?
Good.
Hilarious. They can't find a moving company to help the Chargers move to L.A.
They don't have dirty Russians in San Diego like they got in New York.
Sherrod, we're opening a moving company.
I can get the fucking six Russians to move right now.
I think the story's being blown out of proportion.
Yeah, it's a fake story.
I bet you there's maybe one or two that said hell no, and then, I mean, come on.
Because they're trying to keep the team there?
Dude, that's big business to move a football team.
It's fucked up
for your moving company.
Yeah, doing like the what's the name that in the middle of the night for the Colts?
Yeah,
in Baltimore.
Indianapolis.
Oh, that was dirty. They still talk about that in Baltimore. Yeah. Angry.
It was fucked up.
In the middle of the night.
Can you imagine waking up and your team is no longer in your city? Yeah. That was fucked up.
But you know what? They wouldn't give them a fucking stadium. I went to college in Baltimore. Memorial Stadium.
Shit.
My high school had better facilities. Memorial Stadium looks like, holy shit, I can't even compare. Like, remember, what was the old stadium in Philly?
I know what you're talking.
Because I did an NFL commercial there years ago, and it was like, I was like, unbelievable, this is stone seats. Right. The seats are made out of stone.
That was where the
what are y'all doing?
That's where the Phillies played way back in the day, right?
Yeah, I think so. But that's how Memorial.
I know what you're talking about, but I can't remember. Franklin Field?
It was one of them shits.
That might be right.
I love Maryland. I love that whole
that
area.
That might be right. There you go. Franklin Field, maybe.
When you got an old stadium and you see new shit popping up, it's like, yeah, this can't go on. That's why when they did Oriole Stadium, the new Camden Yards.
Right. Dude.
They used to play. Memorial was just bad, man.
Yeah.
Tiny.
The I love that you mentioned Baltimore moving in middle of the night because you've seen that 30 for 30, right? The band played on.
Oh, so bad.
Oh, if you want to. If you
so
want to.
Brutal.
Oh, so pathetic. So sad. Oh, ESPN plays it like these guys are like local heroes. I'm like, get a life. The band, the so marching sad. Band decided to keep going even though the team was gone and they would show up at all these parades and functions and
that's
and they were rallying trying to get a team back in Baltimore.
They finally did it though. They finally got
it. It had nothing to do
with
the
band. Nothing to do with the band, though. The band
they gave them a little credit for it, but. Oh, that 30 for 30 is so fucking sad. They're just in someone's living room practicing.
The Titanic band had a better future than that.
You've never seen this?
I don't know anything what the fuck you're talking about, but let me just... are you telling me that a bunch of fucking bozos with useless instruments kept playing?
Yeah, because the band was a big part of like the Baltimore scene, the Charm City, and the team.
Right.
I throw kerosene on them.
I think it's called When the Band Played On. Is it called When the Band Played On?
Well, fellas, it's been a pleasure playing with you.
Yes!
Yes! Sink.
Titanic band.
Bubbles.
Oh, I would be gone with my clarinet.
I have to say, fellas. I have to
I'll
say,
be gone with my clarinet.
I would be taking my clarinet and hitting heads on my way out to
Street
make
Opie.
A path.
That would activate Street Opie, the candy man, to knock people out.
Yeah, you make believe it's women and children first.
Fuck all that.
I would just stand to that shit.
Oh, no, but that happens now. Like, I identify as a woman. You see it on the internet. You can do that. Get the fuck away from me.
Oh, I would make it look good, like I was trying to save a woman, and oops, I fell over the side.
How come women want everything equal except for on a sinking boat?
I would float
on women.
It's
like, yo,
equal
pay. You want equal everything, but what is women and children? Fuck that. Children. We all dying, bitch. We adults.
Yeah.
It's called the band that wouldn't die is the official name of the 30 for 30. It is.
That wouldn't die zombie band.
It is amazing.
It is.
That one is a good one.
Oh my God.
They look, they're showing up and people are almost like, oh, will you please stop showing up? It's really, this is really sad. This is really sad now.
It was a hard. And I love Baltimore.
And then there were like band members that were like, hey man, I gotta, you know, and then they're getting shit for leaving the band. Like, yeah. You don't believe in us?
Nobody does. That music sucks anyway.
I gotta watch that one again. It's called The Band. Die.
I'm watching that this weekend.
Fox News Sports, there you go. Moving companies refuse to help.
Fake news.
Chargers relocate to Los Angeles. All right, we should take a break.
All right.
Just an hour and, 15?
How many times the Chargers been back and forth from between shit? Have this stuff...
I don't know.
It seems like so many teams, like the Raiders jumped up and down, California.
West Coast, man.
They don't support. They
soft
shit
the
like...
ice cream.
Yeah. I don't know.
There's no love like the East Coast. Like, when you love the Giants, people will fight you.
It's like, other than the 49ers, every team in Cali moved before.
Yeah.
Everyone.
And Oakland may still end up in Las Vegas. So, or the Raiders, I should say, may end up in Las
Vegas.
That's
definitely happening.
That has to happen. Football in Vegas?
That would be fantastic.
I'm surprised they haven't figured that out yet.
But you build that stadium in a half hour.
Huh?
They'll build that stadium in a half hour.
Oh, my God.
But you know what? They're going to have the same problems they had with UNLV sports. It's degenerates
really?
In Vegas. The players get pulled in. They owe people money. And next thing you know, they fucking up the score.
That'll be the problem.
Oh, that's going to be UNLV, my team.
My girl, my ex-girl, who I'm the prom with from high school, she went to UNLV. And all them dudes had little
action
going on. Because you got a lot of people with big money in your face. And then you owe these people favors in that town. You broke college kid.
Oh, that's going to make football great.
Dangerous. Vegas is dangerous for a professional team.
Yeah, that's a good point.
That's going to be my team.
Saying.
Oh, it's happening, though.
Hmm. A degenerate gambling team? I'll get a tattoo with their fucking thing.
You're going to put a professional sports team in a town that the mob built. And want people to trust it. All right. Go for
Sounds
it.
Good to me.
Go for it.
Sounds good
Lewis,
to me.
Plug something. Your podcast, something.
For yes.
your shitty football picks.
There was no way you're 4-4, baby.
And I don't study the sheets.
I'm still heartbroken.
There was no way a 4-4 was getting a 2-4. No,
I don't study shit.
Podcast is The Loudcast on iTunes. Check it out if you want to hear a shitty podcast.
I'll stop.
And at Cowboys_HotFans if you yes. are a did a nice interview with my man Sherrod Small over great. Here talking nice. About the Cowboys. So check that out on Instagram if you can.
They're
doing
a lot of love.
Season. I read some tweets. I'm going on Race Wars when I'm invited.
Yes, you're invited.
Okay.
I've never been invited.
Dude, it's that best. Is so such a lie.
I've had
tomorrow.
That, I've had the weird invite.
How about tomorrow, Ope?
Sudafed dick.
See? He's like, next Wednesday.
No, I'm going to figure it out.
See?
He's not. No, for real, I'm going to figure it out.
All right.
I'm just fucking around. Sherrod had a good set at Sag Harbor.
Oh, yeah, we had
it
a great
really
show.
It was good?
It was great. It was packed. I partied with the people afterwards. Me, Christian Finnegan, and Joe Vesey was, first of all, the green room there is the greatest because they have a door from the green room that goes right behind the bar.
Oh, wow.
And it's hot bartenders right there ready for your drinks. It's like, okay, every green room should have this.
And radio fans, right?
Packed. I'm feeling took pics. It was great.
I'm feeling it, bro.
Did a lot of high fives. White people on Long Island love high fives.
I'm feeling it. We're going to go to one of your joints soon. Please.
And then I got Poughkeepsie on the 28th, and I'll laugh it up. So, no, everybody, get your tickets for that. That's going to be fucking off the chain.
When is that?
The 28th.
So what's that?
January.
A week from Friday?
Week from Friday.
Thursday, Friday. Week from Saturday?
Week from Saturday, yeah.
Okay, very cool. The Mad Cuban, Carl Ruiz.
Yeah.
On the Twitter. What do you got?
I just want to thank all the Opie guys that came to my restaurant this weekend. Gentlemen.
Yes.
That's what I take this time. Thank you very much. You were nice people.
And they were the best.
They were great people. Thank you.
In person, they're the best.
Thank you.
And they understand to pay cash.
Well, no, just at Pops. Well, we got the credit card machines will be up this week.
Okay.
My wife, because you got to stop this Lone Ranger shit that you're doing. She's like, I know you don't care about your life, but you know you have kids and stuff. I'm like,
well, Lone Ranger is a black man. You know that, though, right?
Is he really?
Goddamn right.
Oh, good.
Learn your history,
I like
brother.
Him even more.
Learn your history, brother.
I
Black Marshall. That's why he was lone, because he was the black dude out there chasing down
the other Marshals would have killed him.
They wasn't working with him.
Exactly.
And he killed everybody who came for him.
That's awesome. I didn't know that.
We got a strong visual for the radio show. It's the YouTube channel, Opie Radio. Up there now, what do we got, Paul? We got Carl basically masturbating to cheese. What else we got up there?
I had to defend it. I couldn't let somebody just come and just
we
cut
got,
that
so we're going to start putting... We're going to start... Interview. We're going to start putting full shows up there. Not every show, but every once in a while when we feel like we got a good one from start to finish. The first one is with Bert Kreischer. That's really good.
Yeah.
And then we got what? Cody Garbrandt's
full interview.
He was yes. awesome in here.
He was great. When is his next fight? Like in the summertime?
Yeah, he said June or July, right?
Yeah.
What else we got? And
Carl getting Jerry Springer a cake.
That motherfucker. It's still not his fucking
birthday.
Still
not his birthday.
That motherfucker.
And then we pissed off a lot of people because me and Carl were babbling during the great debate with Lionel and Jerry Springer. So a lot of good visuals. Check it out if you want. If not, whatever. That's fine. Opie Radio on YouTube. E-Rock to you before a quick break.
New Opie Radio podcast is
finally!
Up.
Yes. Sorry.
The Vincent D'Onofrio saga is up there.
One and two. Did you see on
Pause
cringe?
One and two?
Did you see on cringe?
I like Vin. I invited him on the show again last night.
Yeah, I can't wait till he comes. I can't wait to meet him in person.
His tweet last night was hilarious. And I go, come on, man, it's time. Let's do this. Look at him.
Let the bygones be bygones.
He's got a tiny little Mexican hat on his head. I mean, tiny. And it says, for all you trolls, don't agree with my politics, think I'm a celeb and don't have the right to speak. Look at this picture. Do you really want to get in
to it with
into
me?
It with me?
When this little Mexican, the sombrero.
Looking
on
the last street up, he's like, yeah, sure, why not?
Let's dance.
Uh-oh, you kicked
that's
ass.
The weirdest yarmulke I ever saw in my life.
All right, we're going to talk Ringling Brothers. We're going to talk Warren Mayer Fouts.
What?
Oh, you didn't know about that?
You didn't see it?
Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Brother.
Oh, shit.
Get ready.
What happened?
Sherrod looks...
Oh, boy.
What the fuck happened?
Oh, you're going to have a thing or two to say.
Yeah.
Chuck Berry.
We'll be back.
We'll be back with more Opie Radio.